ताजा समाचार तमारी भाषामां मेळववा माटे डाउनलोड करो गुजराती मिडडे नी एप.
You know, I have to say, like, for instance, of course, there's so many movies that you did and that we all remember. But I think if I were to place you in terms of how you would be remembered the most at this point, I think it's likely to be your playlist is going to be the best, one of the best playlists of the 90s in terms of the songs that you featured in. It's incredible the number of amazing songs that you featured in.
Just before you came and I was talking, I said, you know, it's ironical. I'm not a trained dancer. I'm not a trained actor. I've never done theater, but I'm not a trained dancer. So songs, shows, shooting for a song was a nightmare for me. I went through sleepless nights. I would get acidity because of the stress I was going through. I was always scared of songs. And can you imagine, my career is based
on absolutely.
Even if the movie is not done well, I have done well only because of the songs that I was featured in and the song that is done well. And they've not all been dance numbers. I mean, my first popular song was Sambhala Hai Maine.
Right.
And it was just walking and it was just expressions and whatever. But it's the songs that have carried me through.
I think Major Saab had a phenomenal soundtrack.
Had great
music. Yeah, literally had amazing. But I think the one that breaks the mold, Sonali, is Hamma Hamma, no? Because
item song, as you call it now,
it got invented there, right there and then in that movie, and it goes so well with this podcast because the movie is called Bombay, and it's a film, the Bombay film. Please tell us, take us through the story behind you doing, I think, what was the first item song in Bollywood. Although technically it was a Tamil film, but it was a pan India film,
and it was not shot in Bombay. It was shot in Chennai. It was Maniratnam film, and actually, I felt really bad that I didn't have the movie, but just one song.
Yeah. But you had Hamma Hamma.
You know, it was not Hamma Hamma at that point of time.
Oh, no. What was it?
No, no. I mean, it could be that song.
Correct. We don't know what's going to happen to that song.
I mean, like you said, this whole concept of that one song making something happen kind of happened only after that.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah,
if you were not in a movie, you could have that song in the movie and the movie and, you know, that working for you. But you're doing nothing in the movie.
You just come for that song.
Just for that song. Yeah. Not even for the entire song.
Right.
So that was also the thing. And then, you know, and I remember them saying it. It was also the... I said, why should I do it? Why shouldn't I do it? And there were equal amount of people saying, you shouldn't be doing it. You shouldn't be doing it. Then I said, you know what? But it's okay. I mean, I get to learn something.
Yeah.
And at that time, the challenge in front of me was that I couldn't dance. I had an English Babu Desi name where Saroj Khan was ready to kill me because I couldn't dance and I was playing a bar dancer. Can you imagine what I was going through? I was struggling, you know, like every hour that I was not working, I was trying to learn how to dance. And Ahmed was Saroji's assistant at that point. And I remember Ahmed would bribe me with chocolates and ice cream. He would pick me up from my home in Lokhandwala, take me to a rehearsal hall, and, you know, he would teach me. And it was like, I can't do it. I'm fed up. And he would say, come on, one step more, just once more. This is the chocolate. This is the ice cream. He would literally bribe me like a little child he has taught me. So then when Hamma came and all this happened, and you know this.
So did you land this because English Babu Desi Prem?
No, I don't know why I landed it. Don't know why I landed it. But I remember eventually taking it on and saying that it's going to be. I remember that I was supposed to dance with Prabhu Deva's brother. Prabhu Deva and all was choreography. It was the choreographer. It was going to be Killing Dancing. And I said, you know what? If I'm going to do this and if I'm rehearsing, if I can do this, great. And if I can't, then I know I should be going home. And so it was just something out of that kind of a weird thinking that I said, chalo, I'm going to do it. And I have these 3 days free. I'm getting this much on it. And you know, the people who work with me, unka bhi per day nikal jayega. Chalo, let's do it. I'm going to be sitting.
So it was that. Like I'm doing nothing right now. Let me just do Hamma Hamma.
And see if I'm really worth this. All this dancing that I've been doing, am I going to be able to do?
All that you learned in English Babu.
Yeah. All for the other.
Yeah.
And so I went there and, you know, I remember, you know, going to the rehearsal hall there and, you know, like practicing. And the song was shot like more in really like one shot, literally the whole thing. Then they edited it, but they were doing really long, long shots. And I remember at one point when on the set, Sundaram Masuji, Prabhudeva's father, had come and he gave me that $100 and he said, it's amazing that you did this. And I said, oh my God, I have a place in this industry. I think I can pull this off. and there is something over here that I can look forward to.
Subscribe karo Gujarati Midday. Bell icon par click karine medvo tamam video na direct notification.